sit down in old Key West. The locals all were high. The tourists snapped their photographs and munched their key lime pie. And meanwhile, down at Sloppy Joe's, the drinks were standing tall, with Buffett on the jukebox and Hemingway on the wall. Then up spoke Sam the Shrimper. He said, I've been a shrimper all my life. My daddy was a shrimper, and my mom's a shrimper's wife. And I'm tired of being a shrimper, 'cause this shrimper's life's too tame. So I'm gonna rob the Conch train, boys, and be like Jesse James. Gonna be like Jesse James, boys, gonna be like Jesse James. In case you didn't hear me the first three times, gonna be like Jesse James. Now the Conch train is a tourist toy that rolls through Key West town like some weird ride from Disneyland. It drives the tourists round and round, while the engineer on her PA points out all the sights. Where Tennessee, did you know what? Tourists all have money, said Sam. Their wives have rings of gold. Their mopeds all are pawnable. Their cameras can be sold. And think of all the glory, boys, the money and the fame, to be the first and only man to rob the Key West train. Now the engineer of the Conch train, her name was Betsy Wright. She drove the Conch train all day long and loved Shrimper Sam all night. And with some sweet persuasion, she agreed to join the game. She'd slow it down at Flagler and let him rob the train. The Conch train made its turn down at Smathers Beach, when Shrimper Sam with a snorkel on leaped naked from the sea. His fillet knife was in his hand. He jumped aboard the train. Give up your bucks, you tourist schmucks. I'm Key West Jesse James. I'm Key West Jesse James, boy. Key West Jesse James. In case you didn't hear me the first three times, I'm Key West Jesse James. Now, unbeknownst to Shrimper Sam, in the third car from the rear sat Kelso Bowles from Muscle Shoals, an American Legionnaire. He was a redneck of respect and a marksman of renown. From under his fat, he drew a gat and shot the shrimper down. Now the first time that he shot poor Sam, Sam groaned and clutched his side. The second time he shot poor Sam, Sam fell to his knees and cried. And the third time that he shot poor Sam, you could see in both their eyes got beneath the western skies. We lay poor Sam upon the sand, and we lifted up his hair. We listen close to hear the words the dying shrimper said. He said, "Boys, you know I had my chance, but I went and botched the job. But how can a boy be Jesse James without a train to rob?" Then Kelso Bowles, he took off his hat, and the tears streamed down his face. He said, "Son, I know just how you feel. This world's a changing place. When history is written, they won't recall our names. But I only got to play Pat Garrett, 'cause you played Jesse James." We buried Sam in the southernmost sand, close by the southernmost waves, where sweet Betsy Wright cries tears every night onto his southernmost grave. And on his tombstone see the words, "Stick to your own game. And if you are a shrimper, do not try